Hi everyone, this is Civil Engineering Tutorials and today we'll discuss about Array command in AutoCAD. So don't forget to like and subscribe the channel, also press the bell icon to never miss any updates. I have prepared this video on request of one of my viewer. So let's get started. So using Array command, you can create multiple objects by using a single object, or you can create copies of objects in a rectangular circular pattern. Okay, so first I'll create a rectangle. So REC enter. Now specify first point here. Right click. Go to dimensions. Now specify the length 10 inch. Enter. Now width suppose 10 inch. Enter. Now this is a 10 inch into 10 inch square. Now I'll create multiple objects by using this object. Okay. Suppose here I need to copy this with 5 rows and 6 columns. Okay, I need 5 rows and 6 columns. Okay, and distance between each rows and columns should be 10 inch. Okay, distance between each rows and columns should be 10 inch. Right, now I'll show you what is row and what is column. Now see, these green colors, these horizontal lines, these are rows. Okay, this is one row. This is another row. These are rows. Okay. Green colors. Okay. Now these red colors, you can see vertical lines. These are columns. Okay. These are columns. So this is one row and this is one column. Hope you understand what is row and what is column. This is one column and this is one row. These are rows and these are columns. Okay. Horizontal rows and vertical column. Okay, so here I need 5 rows and 6 columns. Okay, 1 2 3 4 5 rows and vertical 1 2 3 4 5 6 columns. Okay, and distance between each rows and columns should be 10 inch. Remember this. Okay, so for array command you can type array, or you can also use shortcut key of array command, that is AR. AR is the shortcut key of array command. Okay. Now you can select array command from toolbar also. So this is the array command. From toolbar you can also select. Okay. But I usually prefer shortcut key, that is AR. Right. Now AR enter. Now this is the two options, rectangular array, polar array. So first I will show you rectangular array. Okay, so select object, click on select object. Now select the object, this is the rectangle, select the object, enter. Now we need to specify rows and columns. So we need 5 rows and 6 columns. So 5 and make column 6, 5 rows and 6 columns. Next, we need to provide row offset, column offset and angle of array. So click on row offset, click here. So row distance should be provided vertically and columns distance horizontally. Okay, we need to take the distance from end point of object. Okay, this is horizontally column distance and row distance should be provided vertically. Okay, we need to take the distance from end point of object. Okay, means end point object distance, this is the end point, means object distance plus offset distance. Offset distance is 10 inch. Okay, so distance between each rows and columns, that is 10 inch, 10 inches offset distance. So object distance is 10 inch plus offset distance 10 inch. Okay, this is the object distance 10 inch plus offset distance 10 inch. Okay, so here we need total 20 inch. We need to provide 20 inch here. From end point we need to provide 20 inch. So row distance is 20, specify 20. From this point specify 20 inch. Enter. This is 10 and offset distance is 10. Right? Now 20, press enter. Okay, now we need to provide, this is, see, this is 8 inch, means 20 inch. Now we need to provide column offset, so click on column offset. Now we need to click on end point. We need to provide horizontally, so click on end point. Okay, so here we need to provide same thing, object distance plus offset distance. So object distance is 10 inch plus offset distance is 10 inch. Okay, total 20 inch. So 20, enter. Now see, row offset and column offset is 1 foot and 8 inch, means 20 inch. Now angle of array is 0. Okay, this is 0 angle. Now click on preview. Now see, arrow will be like this. So enter, click on OK. Now see, now all objects are created. Okay, hope you understand. Now go to dimension, linear. Now these are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 columns and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rows. Okay, 5 rows and 6 columns, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rows and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 columns, right? So this point to this point means column to column distance would be 10 inch, and this is 10 inch, and rows distance, see, this point to this point, this distance is also 10 inch, right? Here to here, column to column distance 10 inch, and row to row distance 10 inch, right? Hope you understand. Alright, so now I'll show you another example. So go to array, provide array command, AR, enter. Now 5 rows, 6 columns, same. Now row offset 20 inch, column offset 20 inch, means 1 foot and 8 inch. Select object, enter. Now I'll change the angle here. I'll make suppose 60 degree. Make the angle 60 degree. Okay. Now preview. Now you can see. See, angle is changed. Now enter. Okay. Now I'll show you whether this is correct or not. Check line command, L enter. Now press the less than key, 60 degree, enter. Okay, now check the angle, go to angular, see, this is 60 degree. Okay, so all the objects are created with 60 degree, right? Now undo array. Now I'll change the angle, suppose 75 degree. Okay, select object, select the object, enter. Now okay, all dimensions are okay. Now click on OK. Now I'll check the angle, check line command, I'll enter. Now sorry, press the less than key, 75, enter. Now go to dimensions, angular. See, this is 75 degree. So all the objects are created with 75 degree, right? Hope you understand. Alright. Now I'll show you another thing. So take the rectangle again, dimension 10 inch, enter. 10 inch width, enter. Okay, so this is 10 inch into 10 inch square. Now I'll create 5 rows and 6 columns. Okay, array, so 5 rows and 6 columns. Okay, now here row column of row offset. Okay, so row offset, here I'll provide row offset from midpoint. Okay, I'll take the distance from midpoint. Okay, from midpoint, select object. So row offset will be taken from midpoint. I'll take from midpoint. Midpoint means midpoint of object to midpoint of another object plus row offset. Okay, hope you understand. Means here we are taking distance of midpoint to midpoint of another object plus offset distance. So here to here this distance is 5 inch. Okay, this is 5 inch plus offset distance 10 inch plus another object's midpoint to endpoint distance 5 inch. So total 5 inch plus 10 inch plus 5 inch means 20 inch. Same thing. Okay. Here we are taking from midpoint to midpoint of another object. So that is also 20 inch. Okay. 5 inch plus 10 inch plus 5 inch. Same thing. That is 20 inch. So you can take from endpoint or you can take from midpoint. Okay. Enter. So column offset. From midpoint also column offset will be also provided from midpoint. That is also 5 inch plus 10 inch plus 5 inch. So total 20 inch. So provide 20. Enter. Now I change the angle 0. Okay. Now click on OK. See, this is created. All the objects are created. Go to dimension linear. This point to this point, this is 10 inch. Column to column distance 10 inch. Now midpoint to midpoint distance 20 inch means 1 foot and 8 inch. And end point to this point is 1 foot and 8 inch. Right? So here to here this is 10 inch. And row distance, row to row distance 10 inch. Right? So you can take from end point or you can also take from midpoint. That is your choice. This is end point, this is midpoint. Okay. Linear. This is 10 inch. This is 10 inch. And distance, column to column distance, 10 inch. Okay. Now midpoint to end point distance, 5 inch. Okay. So this is also midpoint to end point distance, 5 inch. So this is 10 inch. So 5 inch plus 10 inch plus 5 inch. Total 20 inch. Same thing. Okay. So you can take from end point or midpoint. Okay. End point to, this is my midpoint. You can take from end point to this point. This is the midpoint. This is the end point. You can take end point to this point and the end point to this point or midpoint to midpoint of another object. Okay, both methods are correct. Okay, hope you understand both the methods. Okay, next take a circle. Now this is a circle. Suppose I'll create with 5 inch radius. 5 inch, enter. Okay, now I need here air, enter. Okay, rows, I need to provide rows and columns. Okay, 5 rows and 6 columns. Okay, and row offset and column offset. Okay, center point, this is the end point. Okay, click on end point. Okay, so row offset should be 10 inch. Okay, sorry, row offset here, I need row offset 5 inch. So this is total is, diameter is 10 inch, radius is 5 inch means diameter is 10 inch. So 10 inch plus offset distance 5 inch, total 15 inch. This is 10 inch, diameter is 10 inch because radius is 5 inch. So diameter is 10 inch plus offset distance 5 inch because here I need distance 5 inch. Okay, so total 15 inch. So provide 15 inch, 15, enter. Now column offset should be same 15 inch. So here from end point, I'm taking from end point. This is diameter is 10 inch plus this offset distance 5 inch. So total 15 inch means 1 foot in 3 inch. Okay. Now select the object, enter, now click on OK. See, this is created. Okay, go to linear. Okay, this is 1 foot and 3 inch. Okay, and distance between each rows and column should be 5 inch. Here midpoint to midpoint distance is also 1 foot and 3 inch, and distance between column to column, this is 5 inch, and distance between rows to rows is also 5 inch, right? Column to column distance 5 inch, and row to row distance also 5 inch, right? This is column distance, this is row to row distance. Okay, hope you understand. Now array, select object, enter, row offset, column offset is provided. Okay, now I'll change row offset from midpoint. I'm taking from midpoint. Okay, so midpoint also I'm taking 15. Sorry, row offset is taken vertically. Array, enter, row offset should be taken vertically. So vertically this is 15 from midpoint, and column offset from midpoint 15, same thing. Okay, radius is 5 inch, offset 5 inch, radius of another object 5 inch. Now press on OK. See, dimension linear. Here to here, this is 1 foot and 3 inch means 15 inch. Here to here also 15 inch. Okay, here to here 5 inch. This is 5 inch. Okay, now row distance also 5 inch. Column to column distance also 5 inch. Right? So, this is row distance is also 5 inch. Okay? Hope you understand. All right. So now suppose this is a rectangle. Now I'll create a circle here. Okay. Now I want to make copy of this rectangle on this circle. Okay. Copy of this rectangle on this circle. Okay. So, give array command, AR enter. Now, polar array, I'll use polar array here. Now, select object, select the rectangle first, enter. Okay, now we need to provide center point. Okay, click on center point. Now, center point is here. This is the center point of circle, so click here. Okay, now we need to provide total number of items. Okay, so we need to provide total number, suppose 8. Now angle 360 degree, preview, see, enter, click on OK. See, all the rectangles are created. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So 8 rectangles I created on the circle. Okay, this is the polar array. Again, I'll create again, AR enter, polar array. Okay, select object, select the rectangle, enter. Now click on center point. Now total number, I'll change this, suppose 12. Now I'll change the angle. Suppose I'll make this 180 degree. Okay, now click on OK, preview. See, all the objects are created with 180 degree. Okay, now change this to 360 degree. Again click on preview. See, this is created on 360 degree angle. Okay, so 12 numbers of rectangles are created, right? Suppose I'll change this angle to 90 degree. Preview, see, this all these angles are created with 90 degree angle. And suppose I'll change the number 10 and change the angle to 360 degree again. Now click on OK. See, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10, so 10 rectangles, 10 numbers of rectangles are created on this circle. Okay, so hope you understand how to use rectangle array and polar array. Okay, how to use array command. So hope you like this video. Now if you like this video, then don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching.